K-pop is so rough nowadays, I won't sugarcoat it because it already has been enough. We are in the dark ages of K-pop, which is not a good look considering 5th Gen is quite literally at our doorstep, just waiting to take full effect despite the fact it should have literal ages ago. Anyways, enough about that, we're here to talk K-pop opinions, so without further ado, let's continue on with the video. We don't need any more Blackpink solos. Listen, I get it, as much as they're always iconic, maybe not always the greatest, and while we all love shitting on them just a little bit, any Blackpink solo activity or promotion is a time that we all should cherish, because by the looks of things it seems like they won't be promoting under the Blackpink name anymore. This contract renewal is becoming a little too real life here. What I'm trying to say is, do we really need a follow-up to LaLisa? Do we really need a Flower Part 2? And the fact You and Me by Jennie was so dookie shows how much we truly don't need any more Blackpink solo releases. All of the individual stories and concepts of each solo release is already more than enough, and for the time being they should just stick to OT4 promotion because we are being completely deprived of it. The only member I would actually like to see a solo comeback of is Rose A, because she's possibly the only freaking girly in this group with an ounce of solo potential. And that's not to shit on the other members at all, some idols just suit a group setting more I guess. Gods by NewJeans is not good, oh my, the way you all hyped up this song is actually low-key scary, just think of the possible lawful songs in the future you'll all be hyping up as well if you're okay with having this as a single. I simply will not take it, whoever said this sound suited NewJeans truly needs to go and actually listen to some of their music because what are you on my love? It's giving the girls part 2, hyping up a mediocre song and using it in every short-term form of content on just about every social media platform imaginable. They need to stick to the original sound because this overdramatic, mid-excuse of a single is not going to cut it. Didn't even get any concept photos or music video actually featuring the members. Just bring back KDA, that would actually make some noise. Baby Monster's debut being a digital single is abysmal. We waited for how long? 7 months? 9 months? Years? For not only one of the members to go on a hiatus as soon as the concept photos start rolling out, but the entire debut is just one single song? I mean, we can't be mad at Aeon for going on a hiatus, but when we wait this long for one measly song, that's when it starts to look a little too lazy, especially for YG. I mean, they couldn't even give us a B-side. This just adds on to the timing of Baby Monster's debut being strange because it's becoming ever more clear that this debut is being used as a cover-up for YG's shit and what's going on behind the scenes. And you're all falling for it as well with these comments. Open your eyes people, there is so much more going on that we should really start looking into with this company. Dream Academy lineup over RU next lineup. Oh my, did HYBE absolutely eat up everything with the Dream Academy debut lineup. We got Lara. We got Mon Nguyen, we got just about every main slayer imaginable, but are you next in their debut group on the other hand, yikes. I mean, I've talked about my annoyance towards Isle in past community posts, but I haven't really taken the time to really look into how much more attention HYBE gave the debut Dream Academy. First off, they premiered the Dream Academy like a day after RU Next ended, it's giving another one thank you because not only that, they made the final few episodes of RU Next solo budget to the point it was actually scaring me. I was worried that stage was about to collapse due to how cheap it was starting to look. Take episode 1 stage as an example, then compare it to the final episode stage. It's looking a little rough, I fear. Secondly, the Dream Academy is getting a Netflix documentary. I'm sorry but what? Like, good for the contestants getting that Netflix screen time, but oh my, they really left RU Next in the dust with that one. And lastly, HYBE just cared more and felt more passionate towards the Dream Academy, whether that be in caring more for the contestants, higher budget sets and styling, they just couldn't seem to care one bit for RU Next in the final few episodes especially, and we can see that with how dog-dookie their lineup is. No hate but like, one he getting first place is a crime when we look at some of them fan-cammed and the other contestants that deserved it more and actually took years of training to even get into a HYBE show. Just for it to flop, get bad reviews and be insanely cheap. It'll be interesting to see which group's debut will do better though. VV's Maniac is their best title track, No, because I am seriously so annoyed we all collectively let this album and title track flop, because it's their best yet. You can talk all you want about how Untie is better suited as a title track rather than a B-side, but I genuinely believe that Maniac is such a fun, yet slightly emotional title track, and although it may not be the most perfect choice for this type of album concept overall, it's just such a solid title, the drop in sales as well as such a letdown considering how good this entire release is. The only thing that managed to get talked about at least once this entire comeback was the choreography, and that's not going to carry them to success, I fear. Anyways, this is their best title track. It's definitely not Bop Bop, it's not Love Aid, it for sure isn't Pull Up despite the fact it is slightly overhated. The best VV's title track is without a doubt Maniac. This video was kinda short, but there were just some things I honestly needed to talk about because I swear the K-pop community are the best at sweeping things under the rug and pretending things aren't happening when they very much are. Like VV's had a comeback that didn't rise in sales and literally no one is talking about it, and Baby Monster's debut is looking a little weird as of now, and of course, I as always am the first person to talk about this stuff, just kidding. People have definitely talked about the stuff in this video before me, but just a little reminder, these are my opinions, so if you feel the need to disagree, leave your own opinions in the comments respectfully. Thank you for watching.